Let's talk about how keto, the ketogenic diet, could potentially help protect your immune system, especially when we're talking about the coronavirus. Now check this out. 99.2% of all deaths from COVID-19 are associated with metabolic syndrome. And this syndrome, your immune system is compromised big time. Now, those who do not have other health conditions but die only have a 0.8% chance of dying, versus if you have pre-existing health problems like blood pressure, diabetes, heart condition, cancer, raise your chance of dying to 99.2%. Now, let's take a look at what is the common denominator of some of these conditions. Well, high blood pressure, most cases of hypertension, and I'm talking 90% of all of the hypertensive patients have what's called essential hypertension. Essential meaning they don't know what causes it. I'm gonna put a link down below of this paper that talks about the interrelationship between insulin resistance and hypertension. Insulin resistance in compensatory hyperinsulinemia, that means that you're having high amounts of insulin in the blood as a compensation. So let me just draw this out. Got the pancreas right here. It's sending insulin, okay, into the cells. But you have insulin resistance, right? So it's gonna be low right here. So the signals won't get back to the pancreas. So there's no feedback loop. So if there's no feedback loop to turn it off, the pancreas will make more and more and more and more. And this is why people with insulin resistance have 5 to 7 times more production of insulin. In other words, people with insulin resistance have a tremendous amount of insulin in the body, but it's not working. That's what they mean by compensatory hyperinsulinemia. That means insulin in the blood. Commonly occurs in patients with untreated essential hypertension. The coexistence of insulin resistance and hypertension can be viewed as a cause-effect relationship. Wow, that's powerful. Now, I would imagine this is probably a lot less if you factor in insulin resistance itself, which I know for a fact they rarely test that, and especially with these cases, they're not testing if the person has insulin resistance, which could be a pre-diabetic condition. In fact, in America, it's been estimated that 60 to 70% of the entire population has some level of insulin resistance. So this 0.8% could be, I don't know, 0.2%, bringing this level up to 99.8% potentially. So in summary, what happens when you go on keto? This is what you deal with. This is what you improve. Healthy insulin levels. You basically get insulin to the level where it's no longer high. And guess what? Many times your blood pressure improves. Your diabetes type 2 improves. The cardiovascular system gets improved. And I'm going to put links down below showing those connections as well. Another vital reason why people should do keto, and especially intermittent fasting, to support their immune system so we can actually minimize the risk of dying if the person gets infected. If you want information about insulin resistance, check out this video right here.